the Holy Land over the last 1700 years or so have prepared the way for the dynasty, have prepared the way for the creation of the state of Israel, in the sense that the claim system depended on assuming that the Bible is history and that there is a diaspora, that the Jews were there and were expelled and have roamed the world wandering all over the centuries, and now they're coming home. On the other hand, the association is that the Palestinian history is short term. It begins really with the Muslim conquest. So these are the kind of things that are in people's minds most. On the other hand, there have been over the last 100 years, 150 years, tremendous discoveries that have not been brought into full fruition in terms of as they reflect on the history of Palestine. I'll get into some of these discoveries as I go on. And so, basically, these discoveries, whether they are epigraphic discoveries, you know, or things found in Mesopotamia, or things found in Egypt, or things found in the region of Palestine and Greater Syria, have totally debunked or have totally removed the basis for the claim of the Zionists to a homeland in Palestine. But this, these discoveries have not been realized in terms of an historical view. So there's in a way a contradiction or a paradox that still the situation in terms of people's perceptions, in terms of the Israeli perceptions, in terms of Western perceptions, still maintain these old ideas despite all the discoveries that have debunked and removed the basis for the Zionist claim. So, and the reason that the result of this is these investments that have been placed in the old version of history are such that every new discovery gets interpreted within the same old claim system. So let's say, you know, something like beginning with the discoveries in Mesopotamia or with other things in Egypt and the region, they are reinterpreted to fit into the whole system. And it's because there are institutional investments. I mean, there are all these not only the Zionist claim system, but also the church systems and the synagogues and the religious establishments throughout the West and so forth, which want the old ideas to continue. So in a way, what used to be, this is the best way I can describe it, what used to be ignorance in the past, let's say 200 years ago, and it's still ignorance in the minds of a lot of people, is now deception. So the Zionist system, the Western investments in the Holy Land had to cover up these discoveries or interpret them in a way that continued to hold on to the old ideas. This is where I come from. The last one, I think, and it's very important so that my what I'm saying does not get pigeonholed into an idea that is only about Palestine. Because I think it's an epistemological or knowledge issue. In other words, the history that has been constructed is a fabricated history. The discoveries negate that history. So how do we translate the discoveries into a new vision of the history of the region, which is very central to the belief system of the three monotheistic religions, to knowledge issues everywhere in the world. So I don't want to limit it to Palestine, but generalize it to an epistemological knowledge issue about the world and how we acquire knowledge and how we maintain knowledge. I want to also emphasize that I want this to be also not only an epistemological general voice of knowledge, but also be a Palestinian voice, because I think what we need is more awareness on all sides, more awareness in the West, more awareness among Zionists and Israelis, whose mind has been really distorted by the Zionist claim system, and also most importantly for me, among Palestinians, because there are a lot of ideas that are in the minds of Palestinians that have been inherited, which actually exist in the Zionist claim system. that doesn't get anything on to it. So not only reconstructing the Western ideas about Palestine, but also deconstructing our own history and trying to find an alternative.